Alright, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Sallallahu alaihi sayyidina Muhammad wa alaihi wasallam. So first, we recite Al-Fatiha with the intention that Allah bless our majlis, and we send the bounty that Allah Ta'ala bestow upon us to the Prophet Nabi Sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to the ulama, to the awliya, to the companions, to the Ahlul Bayt, to the family of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and not forgetting our parents and our all of our teacher, either they already they're still living or they already passed away. And for the barakah of the ilm, we send also the bounty to Musannif rahimahullah ta'ala. Al-Fatiha. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله أشهد أن أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أشهد أن أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله حبيبه وصفيه وخليله النبي المصطفى حبيب المجتبى وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله اللهم صل وسلم على نور الأنوار سر الأسرار والترياك الأغيار مفتاح باب اليسار سيدنا مولانا محمد المختار وآله الأطهار وأصحاب الأخيار عدد نعم الله وإفضاله اللهم ارزقنا صدق في القول والإخلاص في العمل اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه اللهم ارزقنا فهم النبيين حفظ المرسلين إلهام الملائكة المقربين بجاه سيد الأولين والآخرين يا حليم خلقنا بخلق الحلم وحققنا بحقائق العلم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم أما بعد. So inshallah today we will start with our Aqidah class in Aqidah Tahawiyah. So before that, I will show some video to motivate us into seeking knowledge, insha'Allah.
An opinion in the Maliki Madhab. He was studying with Malik and he got up to pray Nafila from the circle. And Malik said, what you're going to is not more important than what you're in if the niyyah is sound. Right? Don't think that this is ibadah if your intention is for Allah and you're studying this knowledge. ونقل أيضا عن أحمد ابن حنبل أن رجلا قال له هذا العلم فمتى العمل فقال أحمد ألسنا نحن في عمل Imam Ahmad was asked, okay, this is knowledge, when are we going to act on it? He said, this is action. Studying knowledge is action. Don't belittle what you're doing. Learning knowledge is action. This is from our amal. Malik said, when you learn that speaking is from your action, you'll start speaking less. People say, هذا الرجل لا هو فقط يتكلم. If he's calling people to Allah, it's not just speech, it's action. He's an amal. It's not, I mean, if he's a munafiq, that's another thing, like the Iraqi say, Haji Fadi. You know, for him, but not for the people that are benefiting from him. Right? وقال الشافعي طالب العلم أفضل من النافلة. Imam Shafi'i said to seek knowledge is higher than doing extra acts. وقال سفيان ما أعلم عملا أفضل من طلب العلم. The great Sufyan said, I know of no action higher than seeking knowledge. This is something that I've tried to instill into the Zaytuna students.
Alhamdulillah, we are on the path of seeking knowledge. So inshallah, may Allah Ta'ala ease our path to attain the knowledge of God, to attain the ma'rifatullah, to attain the rida of Allah, to attain all the things that Allah Ta'ala bless, all the good people, the Prophet, the Awliya, the Sahaba, and all the things that we wish to be and what we wish Allah Ta'ala wish us to be, inshaAllah. So to continue, الإمام سيد قال شيخنا المصنف رحمه الله تعالى ونفعنا به بعلومه في دارين آمين قال ذلك بأنه على كل شيء قدير وكل شيء إليه فقير وكل أمر عليه يسير لا يحتاج إلى شيء ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Allah Ta'ala said, the Sheikh said, this is because he is the supreme omnipotent over everything, and everything is in complete need of him. Everything is easy for him. He is not in need of anything, and nothing is like him. And he is attributed with hearing and sight. So, I have another video that page 66. Alright. 66. Okay. Zalika bi annahu ala kulli shay'in qadir. Alright. So, there's one video that sing with this statement, and we watch it together.
It's a very touching story. It also shows the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never ever underestimate the power of Allah. You know, there was a sheikh who mentioned this in Saudi Arabia, and there was a doctor that visited him from Pakistan and told him a story that happened to him. So he says, what happened to me? He says, the doctor who's speaking is a top neurologist, one of the top doctors in Pakistan, or, you know, a very, very good doctor, very hard to meet. It's said that perhaps you'd have to wait months on end before you can get an appointment to see him. So what happened is, he says, I was flying from one city to another, very busy man flying quite often within the country and perhaps even outside. And he says, suddenly, the clouds built up. Huge clouds, and the lightning started striking, and it started pouring, and there was lots of turbulence, and one of the engines was struck and it was damaged. So we had to land. And so what happened is, the landing was at a nearby little airport or a little strip and so on. And when they landed there, it was a remote area. How are you going to repair this aircraft? A few people who were on it, it was a small plane, they were quite surprised because they landed in such a remote place. No one's there to repair it. They would have to wait, definitely. So the doctor asks the captain or the pilot that, you know what, how long are you going to be? He says, no, we're going to be quite long. Well, I need to get to that area. Look, he says, it's just a 3-hour drive by vehicle. So why don't you just go by road? And you know, you can go there and get there. He says, okay, good idea, because this is going to take long. So he decides to go on one of the trishaws, you know, in Pakistan, one of the areas, wherever it was, and he jumped in. And as they started progressing, the clouds built again. And the lightning was striking, and the rain started pouring. And it was pouring so much that their vehicle could not move much more because of the mud and because of everything else. And so it was quite an open area with a bit of farmland. And after a while, they realized, look, we're not getting anywhere. There's a little house here. Why don't we just go there? We can read our salah. Perhaps we can, you know, see, have a bit of a meal or whatever else. And they decided to knock the door. Strange people, strange land, far off, out in the rurals. And so he knocks the door, and he's got his little bag and everything, and he walks in. An old lady happened to answer the door after a while, and they spoke to her saying, look, this is what has happened, and we're going from so-and-so to so-and-so, and we just want a place, we want to read salah and so on. And she said, no problem, you can come in. She had a little musalla, a little sajjada, and she had a little baby on the side, or not a baby, but a child. And the child, every little while, she's actually checking on the child, and she's sitting on that musalla making dua and reading her own salah. These people fulfilled their salah, did whatever they had to. When they were about to leave, they spoke to the old lady saying, you know, thank you very much, jazakumullah khair, and so on. And, you know, we are going, what's happening to this child, you know? So the woman says, look, the child is an orphan. And the child is unwell, not well at all, very sick. And we've been to all the doctors around. And subhanallah, I'm the grandmother of this child. The doctors have told us that there is only one specialist around who can help this child. And we tried to make an appointment, but they asked us to come 6 months later. And it's far away. I've been making dua to Allah ever since that day. Ya Allah, make it easy for us. The child is sick. Make it easy for us, Ya Allah. So the man says, what's the name of that specialist? So the granny says, it's Dr. Ishan. Immediately this doctor burst into tears. burst into tears. Straight away, he burst into tears. Why are you crying? Your dua has just been accepted. For your dua, the thunder came, the lightning came, the engine struck. We came down, we came on the road, the rain came again and stopped us and so on. And do you know what? The rain only stopped after the question was asked. Now it happened. And now the woman starts crying. Subhanallah. And the doctor himself is telling the story, saying, that was me. It happened to me, he says. And he says, I learned that Allah's armies are beyond limits. Allah uses whatever He wants to get what He wants done. It's over. Where in the wildest of the dreams of this person would they have felt or believed that the top man, whom it is semi-impossible to see without big appointments, would actually be driven all the way to the door, knock the door, come in here, read some salah, and they would have to serve the child here. Amazing. Wallahi, it brings tears to the eyes. But the reason I share it with you, every one of us has needs for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just keep calling. Just have yaqeen.
Alright. So, what we want to show is the supreme omnipotent. He is the supreme omnipotent over everything. Okay. So Allah Ta'ala said, Innahu ala kulli shay'in qadir. And He, Allah, has the power to do anything and everything. Al-Fussilat, verse 39. Allah Ta'ala said, the proof for everything is in complete need of Him. Allah Ta'ala, فَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدَا سُبْحَانَهُ وَالْغَنِيُّ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ إِنْ عِنْدَكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ بِهَذَا أَتَقُولُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. They claim Allah has a son. Glorified be He. He is not in need for that, nor for anything. To Him are all that is in the heavens and all that is in the earth. You have no warrant for this. Do you say about Allah that of which you do not know? So, first, we must believe that Allah Ta'ala have power over everything, omnipotent. And the second thing is, we are in need of Allah Ta'ala power. Because we are powerless. In every sense, we are powerless. Okay. And then he said, and that is easy for Allah. Kan? That is easy for Allah. Allah Ta'ala said, وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرًا. And Allah Ta'ala said, proof for He not need of anything, Allahu Samad. Allah is the one who is not in need of anything and everything is need of Him. In Surah Al-Ikhlas, Allahu Samad. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ Allahus Samad. Then in Surah Shura, Allah Ta'ala said, Laysa kamithlihi shay'un wa huwa as-sami'ul basir. The Shaykh is taking this ayah and making it into his matan. He's taking directly from this ayah without any changing. He said, Laysa kamithlihi shay'un wa huwa as-sami'ul basir. Nothing is like him. Okay. First, Allah Ta'ala negates the negative attribute for him, which is mithli. Mithl, tamsil, a likeness to him. Alright, so he said nothing is like him. Then, وَهُوَ السَّمِعُ الْوَسِيرُ. He confirmed that he has an attribute of hearing and attribute of seeing. Alright, so Sayyidi Sheikh mentioned in the Shuruh, he said that Imam Abu Ja'far al-Tahawi bring this ayah from Surah Ash-Shura, ayah 11, which constitute the basis of monotheism, the tawheed. This is the what we say, the basic akidah of our teaching in akidah al-sunnah wal jamaah is laisa kamithlihi shay. Allah Ta'ala, there is nothing similar to him, nothing like him. All right This ayah clearly draws a line between the attribute of the creation and that of the creator. Nothing is like him, no matter what one can imagine, conceive or capacitate, Allah is different from that. Anything we can imagine in our mind are not Allah. Anything we can conceive in our mind about the zat of Allah Ta'ala, the what we call the essence of Allah Ta'ala, then it is different, and or we can capacitate that. The understanding of incapacitation to capacitate and encompass him is the correct understanding. The correct understanding is what? Is we cannot capacitate him or encompass him in our mind. No. The ayah also mentioned two attributes, the hearing and the sight. These are among the attributes of Allah Ta'ala, and they are like the rest of his attribute, eternal, everlasting, qidam, baqa, al-awwalu, al-akhiru, not created, okay, qiyamuhu binafsi, and not subject to change. Okay, not subject to change. And then Allah Ta'ala said, the Sayyidi Shaykh said what? Anthropomorphist people argue that this ayah is the proof that Allah has attribute that's similar to human. This is what they're saying. Okay? Just vary in what? In the shape, form or magnitude. Of course, this is a blasphemous belief, and here is how they were confused. It is true that humans are attributed with hearing and sight, and Allah also is attributed with hearing and sight, like what being mentioned. Innahu huwa sami'ul basir. Allah Ta'ala said, okay, although the name of the attribute is similar, but that is the extent of this sharing relationship. That's just that, what we said, the similarities only in the name. Alright, the similarities only in the name. But the haqiqah, the reality is totally different. It's not about the how or the magnitude or the form or the shape. No. The different are the similarity only in the name. Same like when Allah Ta'ala attribute in the heaven, we have some fruits, right? We have some alcohol in the wine, things like that in the Al-Quran, right? In Surah Waqi'ah, kan? Allah Ta'ala said, Ashabul Yamin, Ashabul Shimal, Ashabul Yamin, Ashab apa ni? As-sabiqun al-awwalun, right? Then Allah Ta'ala attribute something in the, there is a river in the heaven, there is a plant in the heaven, there is some tree in the heaven. So all that thing is just about name. It's totally different. Yes, Allah Ta'ala mentioned about teen, what is teen in not pomegranate, fig, right? Fig is one of the fruit of the heaven. But is it similar like here? No, totally different. So if even the makhluk, even the created things also different from this world, from the another world, but about the creator of the creation. So it's totally different. So the sharing of the attribute of Allah and us is about the name. Okay? That is the extent. In other words, nothing else other than the name of the attribute is common between the hearing and the sight of human and that of Allah Ta'ala. Why? Sayyidi give some istidlal. Sayyidi Sheikh said, because why? Our hearing and sight are due to many reasons and are dependent on many factors. To enumerate a few, Sayyidi Sheikh said, this is the few. A primary, we hear because Allah will for us to hear. That's first. The second one, we have an organ of hearing, which is the ear. Third one, we also have inner, middle and outer ear. This is medical lah. Yeah. So, yalah, doktor yang tulis kan? So, tak apa. Each with a specific role to amplify the noise. This noise must be recorded and interpreted in our brain to appropriately respond and analyze. We also have to have the appropriate nerve and blood supply. Moreover, we necessitate a sound wave on a certain frequency to hear them. Suitable environment for transferring the sound wave, etc., etc. Our hearing increase or decrease due to age, disease, or other factors. Our hearing had a beginning and will have an end. Some are even both deaf, some have varying degrees of hearing loss, etc., etc. If anything goes wrong or is faulty with any of the factors, then our hearing is impacted. Okay? That is for us, for our hearing. But for Allah, Allah Ta'ala is attributed with hearing simply as such. Allah Ta'ala is here, anything. Alright? Whether it is something that can be here or not for us. Right? What I mean by that is our Aqidah Ahlussunnah Wal Jamaah said that Allah Ta'ala hear everything, everything that exists, even though it's not making any sound, like this wall. Right? This wall, even there is two opinions lah. The majority of the scholars in the Aqidah Ahlussunnah Wal Jamaah said Allah Ta'ala even can hear this wall. Right? The jamadat, the things that are not living, right? We said even, but in physics we said the things, they have what, potential energy, right? So even potential energy, they have slight movement, right? Slight movement. So even them have a wave. Wave have the sound. Wallah alam, right? So Wallah alam. So is it the thing, the wave that Allah Ta'ala hear or not? Wallah alam. But we say Allah Ta'ala hear as such. His attribute is eternal, everlasting, not created and not subject to change. Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is not attributed with having organs or limbs. Allah Ta'ala doesn't have an ear to hear. Alright? Allah Ta'ala doesn't have to have an ear to hear. Okay? And no sound wave, frequency decreasing or increasing, hearing power, no. So, but for Allah, no, this wave frequency doesn't, Allah Ta'ala doesn't care. Allah Ta'ala just hear all the things. All of that implies change, and Allah Ta'ala is not attributed with organ, limbs or change. The same applies to the rest of the attributes of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Okay, when we said we have power, Allah Ta'ala also have power. Yeah, it's totally different. When we said we have an irada, what we call irada? The willings. Allah Ta'ala willings. We also have willing, but it's totally different. Okay, totally different. Just the name, right? Just we sharing the name with Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala attributes. Okay. It's like this. The example of the scholars in Tasawuf said, even though it's not completely true, but it is like that. The analogy is like that. When we are out, when the light reflect our body, we have a shadow, right? So is our shadow similar to us or different to us? It's not really similar, but it's also not a different things from us, right? But is he share our hearing? No. But is it different from us? No, not also. So that's the analogical things that when we said we attributed things that from Allah Ta'ala attribute himself, and we also have the like kind of Allah Ta'ala attribute is totally different. Like the attribute of shadow of us is different from ourselves. Okay? That's the simple analogy lah. Right? Simple analogy. Okay. Then he said, خَلَقَ خَلْقَ بِعِلْمِهِ وَقَدَّرَ لَهُمْ أَقْدَارًا وَضَرَبَ لَهُمْ أَجَالًا. Allah Ta'ala said, the Sheikh said, خَلَقَ خَلْقَ بِعِلْمِهِ. He created the creation according to his eternal knowledge and will. وَقَدَّرَ لَهُمْ أَقْدَارًا. He destinies for those he created. وَضَرَبَ لَهُمْ أَجَالًا. He assigned to them fixed lifespans. Okay, so what it mean, Allah Ta'ala, when he make something, he make things that he has knowledge of. Okay, alright. Let we make a simple analogy. Everyone, do you want to have ayam cap for lunch? Yes? Ayam cap. Yeah, exactly. We do not want anything that we do not know. Actually, I just make the chicken, right? There is no. If you want to make a product after this, you can lah, kan? No, watermarks on that. But yeah, that's the idea. We do not do things that we do not have the ilm, the knowledge for that. That is also for Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Allah Taala do whatever He knows. Okay. And وَقَدَّرَ لَهُمْ أَقْدَارَهَا, and he destined the destinies for all those he created. Means all the makhluk, all the alam, all the worlds, Allah Ta'ala already destined their destiny. Okay? And he assigned to them fixed lifespans. Alright? The dalil for that, Allah Ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اُعْبُدُ اللَّهَ رَبُّكُمْ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِي مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Oh people, worship Allah, the one who created you and those before you, so you may succeed. Okay? And Allah Ta'ala proved that he destined for those he created, إِنَّهُ إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ. Allah Ta'ala said, we have created everything with a specific destiny, decree and mission. Okay, so Allah Ta'ala had decreed us when we are born, when we will pass away. Okay, so where and when and how, all that Allah already destined for us, for us. Okay, and then the proof for he assigned to them lifespan, Allah Ta'ala said, ولكل أمة أجل فإذا جاء أجلهم لا يستأخرون ساعة ولا يستقدمون. Allah Ta'ala say, and for every nation, everybody, there is a fixed term. And when it comes to end, they cannot put it off for an hour, nor advance it. Our lifespan, if for 60 years, it will be fixed for 60 years. Not even a single second will delay or will be forward. No. Okay? Well, not even a single second. Okay? And then the Shaykh said, وَلَمْ يَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ شَيْءٌ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَخْلُقَهُمْ وَعَلِمَ مَا هُمْ عَامِلُونَ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَخْلُقَهُمْ. Nothing was hidden from him before he created them. He eternally knew whatever his creation would do before he created them. Then this, Allah Ta'ala said in Al-Quran, هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَسَوَّاهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. He is who created for you all that is in the earth. Then turned he to the heaven and fashioned it as seven heavens. And he is all knower of all things. So nothing is hidden from Allah Ta'ala. Why? Because Allah Ta'ala is the creator of the seven heaven and the fashioner of the seven heaven and what is in the seven heaven. Okay? And Allah Ta'ala said the dalil for the he knew what his creation would do before he created them. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. Say, this is one of the dua for the student of knowledge to make. سُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. They say, glory to be you, O Allah. We have no knowledge but that which you gave us. You are the all-knower, the all-wise. Okay? This is the attribute of Allah. Allah Ta'ala know everything, whichever, and we know the things that Allah Ta'ala give us the knowledge about it. Okay? So, what I mean by that, there's so many things that we do not know. And we just know things that Allah Ta'ala give us the knowledge about it. So, and Allah Ta'ala doesn't give anything to everybody. Everything to every single of his creation, no. That's why when Allah Ta'ala created Adam, Allah Ta'ala give him the knowledge of all the names, right? And Allah Ta'ala asked the malaika, the angels, do you know this, do you know that? The malaika say, yeah, we do not know. Even though they are the maybe we can say, one of the oldest creation after the water and anything, the light or other things. The one of the first worshipper of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is the angels, right? But even they do not know what's the names that Allah Ta'ala has teach Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. Okay? So glorify to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Then Allah Ta'ala said, then the Shaykh said, wa amarahum bi ta'atihi wa nahahum an ma'siyatihi. He ordered them to obey him and forbade them to disobey him. Allah Ta'ala said in Al-Quran, say, قُلْ أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah Ta'ala said, say, obey Allah and the Messenger, but if they turn away, Allah does not like the disbelievers. Okay? So Allah Ta'ala said, obey Allah and the messenger. That's why anything that the messenger do or ask us to do, we do it. Or when the prophet negate us to do anything, then we don't do it. If the prophet and Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala doesn't mention anything, and then it's open to the principle of the Sharia. If this doesn't negate anything, doesn't cross any boundaries, then it is okay. It's called permissible things. So then there's so many things about the permissible things that the people do, and it's open to the discussion and open to the uruf and things like that. So Allah Ta'ala have mercy to us, alright? So alhamdulillah. And the khilaf between the different opinions between the scholars are the rahmah for we people, we are us. Alright? Then the Shaykh said, وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ يَجْرِي بِتَقْدِيرِهِ وَمَشِيئَتِهِ وَمَشِيئَتُهُ تَنْفُذُ لَا مَشِيئَتَ لِلْعِبَادِ إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ لَهُمْ فَمَا شَاءَ لَهُمْ كَانَ وَمَا لَمْ يَشَاءَ لَمْ يَكُنْ. Everything happened according to His decree and will. His will is executed, not our will. This is the aqidah, right? Not our will that being executed. We have our will, some of our will are being executed. We have what we will of, for, and some of our will and many of them are not being established. Why? Because the will that is executed is His will. Okay? The will of creation cannot overcome His will. What He wills occurs, and what He does not will could never happen. That's why when Allah Ta'ala, when the Nabi, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Sayyidina Mu'az, the Prophet said, Ya Mu'az, Ya Ghulam, Sayyidina Mu'az, if I'm not mistaken. Is it Sayyidina Mu'az? Ya Ghulam, inni uhibbuka fillah. No. Ya Ghulam, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to one of the younger sahabah, he ride the camel, if I'm not mistaken, with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then the Prophet said, Ya Ghulam, oh boy, ihfazillaha yahfazka. You protect the religion of Allah, Allah Ta'ala will protect you. Ihfazillaha yahfazka. You jaga Allah Ta'ala punya agama, Allah Ta'ala akan jaga. The literal meaning, if you protect Allah, Allah Ta'ala will protect you. But the means is to protect the religion of Allah. Then the hadith is quite long. At the end, the Prophet say what? If all the people in the world want to give you some goodness, and Allah Ta'ala doesn't will the goodness to be to you, then you will not be given that. And if all the people in the world want to give you some bad thing, and Allah Ta'ala doesn't wish for you, wish that for you, then you will not happen to you. Rafi'atil aqlam wa jaffatis suhuf. The pen already being leaf, and the ink already dry. So what is mean by the ink already dry is mean the will of Allah already they being put to the cannot be changed already. Okay? So yes, he said, وَإِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا عِنْدَنَا خَزَائِنُهُ وَمَا نُنَزِّلُهُ إِلَّا بِقَدَرٍ مَعْلُومٍ. And there is nothing but with us are the source thereof, and we give it in the appointed measure. Allah Ta'ala said, Allah Ta'ala will give. But when Allah Ta'ala want to give? Okay? Allah Ta'ala will give anything that He want to give. At what he want to give it. Okay? So when we make a dua, just keep asking. We do not know, because the act of dua is ibadah. It's not really about we want what we ask for. Yes, no, the main point for our dua, yeah, we want to have anything that we want. But for scholars, for the awliya, their dua is just a mere of ibadah, just a mere of to showing that we are faqir, we are in the neediness of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. That's all. That's why Imam Al-Haddad in his qasidah, he said, what? Qad kafani ilmu rabbi min su'ali wa ikhtiyari. Kan? Fa du'ai wa ibtihali shahidun li iftiqari. He said, qad kafani ilmu rabbi, it's enough for me, it's enough for me. Qad kafani ilmu rabbi, it's enough for me the knowledge of my God about myself, about the condition of myself. Min su'ali wa ikhtiyari. From I do not need to ask him waqtiyari or to do anything. This the reality, not about the action. Then he said, fadu'ai wabtihali, but my prayers and my ibtihal. Ibtihal is merayu, rintihan. What in English? Begging, my begging to God in the darkest night. Shahidun li is the proof of my neediness to God. That just that the awliya said. Why the prophet, when people are comparing between the prophet Ibrahim alaihi salam and the prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the prophet Ibrahim being throw into the fire, the malaikat Jibril came down, the angel of Jibril came down alaihi salam and asked, Oh, Nabi Allah, oh the Prophet, do you not have anything to ask? He said, I just ask from God. Doesn't have anything to ask to God? I will send it to God. He said, do God know about my condition? Yeah, God know lah. Then, of course, God know. Then he said, then it is enough for me. Allah Ta'ala bukan tak tahu. Allah Ta'ala can do anything he want to do. There is the pasrah, the redha, the how he's totally submit himself to the knowledge of God, to the will of God and to the power of God. This is the Prophet Ibrahim alaihi salam. Subhanallah, is this maqam is very high. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the war of Badar, the peperangan Badar, the Prophet asked God until he's making a sajdah and making a prayer in tears until Sayyidina Abu Bakar say, ya Rasulullah, why you ask so very intensely like this? Allah Ta'ala hear you. You're the beloved of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. But that's in the hikam of Ibn Atta'illah. Ibn Atta'illah said that is the maqam of kamalah, the station of completeness. The station of Sayyidina Ibrahim, the Prophet of Ibrahim, is at the high maqam. But the Prophet maqam, the Prophet station is the complete one. Why? Because the Prophet know, even though God are loving the mu'minin and things, but God can do anything he want to do. Even he are promising to protect his religion, this religion, Islam, but he can do anything he do. If he want to perish us, yeah, he can. That's why the Prophet asked really intensely, God, oh God, if you're not making us win this war, then there's no people will submit to you, will submit to Islam anymore. So that's the different, right? That is different. Okay. Allahu Akbar. So then he said, yahdi may yasha wa ya'simu yu'afi fadla wa yudillu may yasha wa yadkhulu wa yabtali adla. Allahu Akbar. He said, he guides wherever he will. Kan, innaka la tahdi man ahbabta walakin Allah yahdi may yasha. Kan, when the Prophet said, right, this one of the problem that we do not discuss. What I mean we do not discuss is mean that we leave to Allah what happened to the uncle of the Prophet. But when Allah Ta'ala said, innaka la tahdi man ahbabta walakin Allah yahdi man yasha, you do not guide who you love, but Allah Ta'ala guide whoever he wills. This is the dalil. Kan, Prophet love so many people, but not all the beloved people to the Prophet are Allah Ta'ala giving guidance. It's not means that the Sayyidina Abu Talib is on the either side. The scholars are disagreeing about this matter. Okay. Disagreeing about this matter. The most popular one is, yeah, he's not from the Mu'minin, but the dalil is not confirmed. Alright, the dalil is not qat'i. So, just leave it to that. No, the problem that being arguing in the Islamic history is Sayyidina Abu Talib, the uncle of the Prophet Abu Talib bin Abdul Muttalib, the uncle of the Prophet, the one that the guardian of the Prophet, the patron of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is he considered as believers or not? Alright, some in the hadith said the least people in the fire that having the seksa, what we call punishment in the fire, is the Abu Talib, the less. But the hadith, like all the scholars say, is not qat'i. It's not, we cannot base our akidah on that matter, on that hadith. Because why? Because there is another hadith that the Al-Abbas, the son of Abu Talib, said that yes, the Al-Abbas, not the son of Abu Talib, but the brother of Abu Talib said, I hear ya Rasulullah, he take the shahadah. Okay. But Rasulullah said, I do not hear that. So from, but the hadith is da'if, is not strong. So based on both dalil, we cannot justify anything. We just said we leave it to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. And the ayah Quran is not really means that he in the fire. No, Allah Taala just merely mentioned that, oh Prophet, you are not the reality that giving the guidance. Allah Taala the one who guide anyone he want and protect anyone he want. Okay, that's the difference. Alright, so then he said, وَيَعْصِمُوا وَيُعَافِي فَضْلًا, he protect them and keep them safe from harm out of his kindness and generosity, فَضْلًا. But وَيُضِلُّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ, and he lead astray wherever he wills, degrades them, وَيَدْخُلُوا وَيَبْتَلِي وَيَخْذُلُوا, abase them, disgrace them, and afflict, وَيَبْتَلِي, and afflict them with tribulation and things, adalah, out of his justice. Okay, so the proof for his guidance, he said, zalika hudallah yahdi bihi man yasha min ibadihi walau ashraku la habita anhum ma kanu ya'malun. Such is the guidance of Allah, where is he guides whom he will of his creation, but if they associate anything with him, all they did would be erased. Okay, Allah Almighty give guidance to whomever He wills, He likes. In other words, He creates guidance in the heart and mind of those of some people. He also protects and guards some, all due to His kindness and generosity. And the proof, He led astray of the people. Walau syaa Allah la ja'alakum ummatan wahida walakin yudillu man yasha wa yahdi man yasha wa la tus'alunna amma kuntum ta'malun. Allah Ta'ala said, had Allah will, He could have made you all one nation. Means all the people in the world are Muslim. But no. But He sent whomever He will astray and guide whom He will. And you will indeed be asked of what you used to do in your life. But what is mean by the last sentence is, don't ask why Allah do this, why Allah do that. But you are the one will be us. No. Allah Ta'ala do whatever He want to do. Alright? Allah Ta'ala do whatever He want to do. We have nothing. The example is like this. You know, does anyone know any filmmaker or director or CD? You know anyone? This is our filmmaker lah. Right? You know director, when he want to make one people bad, this is the hero, this is the one the bad, this is going to die, this one will be the muka pecahnya, yeah, this one. So can we argue with the director? Director, I don't like this script. Are you out? Right? He can do anything he want in his script. So Allah Ta'ala can do anything in his creation. As simple as that. That's the analogy. Can we argue with the director? No, you will not be getting out from the film. Right? So Allah Ta'ala is the director of this life. So he can do anything he want to do. He want to make us, alhamdulillah, as Muslim, alhamdulillah. And that is from the grace of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the bounty of Allah. Subhanallah. We have been choosing to be given the blessing from Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Okay? Wa kulluhum yataqallabun fi mashi'atihi bayna fadlihi wa 'anli. All the creation is subjugate by his will, moving between his generosity and his justice. And wahuwa muta'alin 'anil adad wal andad, he is above being attributed with opposite or equals. Walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Or in this verse Allah Ta'ala said, hum ta'lamu lahu samia, do you know anything similar or equal to him? Allah Ta'ala asked. This is what we call sajalah nak tanya, kan. Memang tahu tak ada. Saja Allah Ta'ala always use this kind of question. Okay, then he said la radda li qada'i, no one can ward off his decree, wala mu'aqqiba li hukmihi, and no one can void his sentence, and no one can overpower his command, wala ghaliba li amrihi, the proof of that he is who given huwa alladhi yuhyi wa yumit, he it is who give life and give death, if he wants a thing he wills for it to be and it is, and the no one can void his sentence and no one can overpower his command. He said wallahu ghalibun ala amrihi walakinna aktsaran nas la ya'lamun, Allah will be executed but most people do not know. And this is the problem of people when they are having problem with God. They say, why God do this, why God do that? They asking about the things that God do. And so there is a hikmah on that things, and we already run out of time. So we will discuss in the different class, inshallah. Then he said, this the last one, he said, amanna bidhalika kullihi, in this chapter, wa aiqanna anna kullam min indi, we have complete faith in him and firmly believe that everything happens due to him. This is our belief. People, whatever are happening in this earth, whatever happening in our life, whatever, every single thing, we've been bite by mosquito, even that single thing, all are everything happen due to him. All are because of his willing and his power. Nothing will happen to us outside from Allah Ta'ala willing. So that's why we learn tasawuf, why we learn the tazkiyatun nafs, is to submit ourselves to God's will. That's all. It's not mean that we do not do our work, no. But just to train us to have full faith to God, full, complete submit to God willing. That's all. God can do anything he wants. That's why the awliya, they say the awliya, when God put them in the in the shade, they do not want to go to the heart of the sun. But when God put him under the sun, he don't want go to into the shade. That is the attribute of the awliya. He submit to it, whatever God give it to them. It's not mean that don't go to the shade lah. No, just how their heart feeling, how their submit themselves to God. That's all. It's not that the fiqh in that things, the action in that things, Sharia said, yeah, don't harm yourself. Go to the shade. Then if not, you will get heat stroke, things like that, right? So the fake is one thing, but our heart is with God. We accept anything that he put it to us. That the things. Okay? Wallahu ta'ala alam, sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sallam. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.